Hi, my name is Thibaut Godon, PhD student in computer science from Laval University. I will present our work on an interpretable machine learning algorithm designed for omics data. Here is an overview of the background and our contribution. The set covering machine is an algorithm that produces powerful and interpretable models based on a conjunction of rules defined from the features. It has been successfully applied in biomarkers discovery for genomics, as shown in several recent works. Other omics data, like metabolomics for example, are more noisy, and the biomarkers are more complex patterns. The set covering machine was limited in this context. To address that, we improved the method and developed the random set covering machine. First, I will introduce the particularities of the omics data, then focus on the algorithm we developed, and finish with the results. Data come from case control studies, where half of the patients represents the phenotype of interest. For example, they suffer from a certain disease. And the other part are healthy controls. Our goal is to find biomarkers, that is to say, measurable characteristics that are predictive of the phenotype of interest. Finding biomarkers will allow to better understand the biological processes involved. This could lead to the development of diagnostic tests, therapies, and drug treatments. Metabolomics is one of the ways to study the metabolism. This data is challenging for most computational methods because of its characteristics. Untargeted mass spectrometry is used to estimate the concentrations of thousands of metabolites, typically from 5,000 to 20,000. Relatively, the number of samples analyzed is small, typically hundreds of patients. This setting is known as FAT data. Classic statistical methods and machine learning algorithms are designed for big data, and they may not perform well on FAT data. In this setting, most of those methods are prone to overfitting. So we can say that there is a need for algorithms specifically made to handle FAT data. One of such algorithms is the set covering machine. Here is a description of the set covering machine algorithm. It produces a conjunction of rules. Each rule is made of one feature and a threshold on the value of this feature. On the prediction phase, the sample is confronted to the rules. If its feature's values respect all the rules, the predicted outcome is 1. Otherwise, the predicted outcome will be 0. On the learning phase, the algorithm builds the optimal conjunction. It involves to find an approximative solution to the minimal set cover problem. A set covering machine model can be seen as a decision tree restricted to only one branch. Note that it is a very sparse model. Theoretical results rely on this sparsity to guarantee that it does not overfit. The set covering machine is limited to learning a single conjunction of rules. We hypothesize that this may limit its ability to detect more complex biomarkers like metabolic paths. We therefore propose the random set covering machine. Following the idea of random forest, we applied the bootstrap aggregation principle to the set covering machine. Several set covering machines are trained on subparts of the data. Once the model is built, its prediction is the majority prediction among the set covering machines that compose it. We can reformulate it by saying that random SCM is built with SCMs as elementary blocks, the same way a random forest is built with decision trees. The first step in the evaluation of the algorithm is to assess the predictive performances, then evaluate its ability to identify pathways as potential biomarkers. This first dataset is composed of 200 samples with 15,000 putative metabolites, and a label indicating the diet of the participants. Here, the accuracy of the random SCM have been compared to the scores of other common approaches in metabolomics: partial least squares discriminant analysis, decision tree, random forest, and support vector machines. We also added the set covering machine to evaluate the need for a more powerful model. First, we observe that the random SCM reached the same levels of performances than other algorithms. Second, we see that the random SEM outperformed the SEM, confirming our hypothesis that there will be benefits to make SEM models more powerful. Third, random SEM overfits less than random forest and other algorithms, showing the benefits of using more simple models like conjunctions instead of trees. Similar results were obtained on other datasets, where the task was either to predict diet, cardiac risk, or cancer phenotype. Let's continue to the next step of the evaluation of the algorithm, the ability of random SEM in biomarkers discovery. We hypothesize that random SEM relies on metabolic pathways to make its predictions. The model is composed of an ensemble of conjunctions of rules based on features. We can then count the number of times some features appear together in the same conjunction. If we count the number of occurrences of the feature that appear the most, it is possible to compute an univariate analysis of the dataset based on this feature, as shown in the first figure. Typically, the list of most used features is about 10 to 30 top features. That makes it human readable. If it's not sufficient, we focus on the pairs of features that are the most frequently used together and represents the distribution of the classes based on these two dimensions. That's the second figure. The third figure shows the projection of samples using three features. And so on, it is possible to increase the number of dimensions to analyze until we find the size of the conjunction of rules that separate well the two classes. To conclude, we can say that the random set covering machine is an algorithm that performs well in high-dimensional metabolomics data. The evaluations of the results in predictive performances and biomarkers discovery prove that it achieves a good trade-off between complexity and interpretability. In the future, we intend to investigate the abilities of this algorithm in other omics data. Thank you for your attention. Please note that a Python implementation of the random SEM is available on GitHub. Here is my email address. Don't hesitate to contact me.